LSU is more effective when Alexis Morris is the ball handler.
Morris pokes that one away. Reese is going to give it to her, and it's Alexis Morris with the layup. Angel Reese hesitated. That shot rolls out. Jasmine Roberts gets it to fall. Bull recovers. Here goes Lashae Dwyer. Up ahead to Roberts. Patience. Back-to-back buckets. Miami in its very first Elite Eight, seeking its first Final Four. LSU looking to get to a sixth Final Four today of 8 points.
So in the Oklahoma State game, they came back from 17 down. When they played Indiana, they kept that same mentality. They were playing as if they were behind.
Spearman in for Miami, number 32 in orange. Jaleah Williams saw an opening and took all of it.
LSU is really finding it hard to find ways to get the ball to Angel Reese.
Yeah, Angel Reese is 0-for-4 as Alexis Morris scored. Now, Kim Mulkey told us she was expecting to see multiple defenses from Miami. Carla Arrivetz on the move in transition, and she scores right over Alexis Morris.
I wonder if they're having flashbacks.
Jasmine Roberts at the elbow.
Jasmine Roberts definitely has that swag. Jaleah Williams trying to dump it off. Back the other way, Flage.
LSU is going to need to hit from the perimeter to open up the paint.
She's already set an LSU single season record in free throws made and free throws attempted. She's attempted more free throws this season than any other player in the nation.
And I know that Flage Johnson has a big personality like Angel Reese, and anytime, and she has great respect for Angel Reese, so if Angel Reese has challenged her, I can expect that she's going to try to turn it up, but right now.
Beat Villanova on Friday. LSU cannot stop.
Forcing Angel to miss inside, but be in position then to not allow her to get the offensive rebound.
Hang on there, Coach Beck.
You see, Miami is icing the screen, not allowing Alexis Morris to come off the screen, and Angel Reese is away from the basket.
Samaya Smith with another offensive rebound and the putback. We have not had a three-pointer made in this game by either team. Morris back to Samaya Smith. She's driving into the lane.
That's a freshman.
Not sure what the stoppage was. It was not a foul call.
How about we get to the free throw line? Courtney, as you mentioned, no free throws by Miami in that first half. Also, 0-for-9 for Miami from deep. She wants to see some three balls falling.
Now, we haven't seen a three ball on either side, Brooke.
We knew these teams love to score in the paint, so that's not too surprising, but I am surprised that Destiny and Angel have yet to hit a shot.
Right on cue, she heard you. Angel Reese with her first field goal of this game.
The fifth leading, number 5 in the country in scoring.
Oh, a slam down by Spearman!
And Miami's defense has everything to do with it. The rotation is there, flooding the paint. The help is there. And then...
long two from Flage Johnson.
We saw her hit a shot and just her shoulders drop like, finally.
Swatted away by Samaya Smith. And then the foul. Wide open lane for Kateri Poole. She misses.
You heard her tell Brooke going into the half, I'm just going to continue to get my shots and take them. My teammates cheering me on.
Cavender has been smothered all day.
You know, 1-for-6 for Haley Cavender, Miami's leading scorer.
Really solid move from Lola Pendande.
Well, you have Caitlin Clark that can just light it up from everywhere, going against Louisville. Louisville has struggled early in the season, but their defense seems to have gotten locked in. So this is going to be a fun one that follows us today.
Jasmine Roberts' shot rattles out. What's got to change for Miami?
They're going to have to stop turning the ball over.
Morris got it back. Kateri Poole left open. We have a three-pointer, folks.
She struggled to score tonight, just 1 for 6. Harden. And the putback by Spearman.
Well, Miami had 3 double-digit comeback games in the regular season. They can get turned up.
There goes Lashay Dwyer. She has been in foul trouble a lot of this game.
You mentioned the contact issue. Destiny Harden spent a good portion of that timeout trying to get her contact back in. So that could be affecting her vision, CP. I mean, not having a great shooting night, maybe she can't see.
Lashay Dwyer shakes off Alexis Morris. To Virginia Tech, they called it Camp Miami, worked on the fundamentals, went back to the basics. Alexis Morris, you need a bucket. 1.2 on the shot clock for LSU. Just throw it up for Angel Reese.
Now, Miami's got to press right now and try to force a turnover, but you got to protect the basket.
Well, Deja Williams got loose.
They want to create, and Katie Meyer is trying to ask her team to do so, but they can't catch Alexis Morris.
She's too quick. The last second bucket, 22 points for Jasmine Roberts.
Big-time player, Destiny Harden.
Kim Mulkey's working magic at LSU. The Tigers back to the final.